So that's the sound of the Ensoniq VFX-SD. Very digital, but super warm, as I'm sure you can hear. Like, this sound especially is just really, I don't know, it's always struck me as quite analog sounding. This is actually one of the presets. I have actually made a whole bunch of my own sounds for this. I've had this synth for ages. This was actually my first vintage synthesizer. I bought it probably, shit, like early 2000s. But my first synth was a Microkorg when they were brand new. My first hardware synth, I should say. But this was my first vintage. So I'll just run through a few presets which I've made. Maybe some of them will be presets which I've just kept because I thought they were good. From the defaults. But then I'm actually going to just make a sound and show you some of the interesting features of this classic synth. It's classic in my mind anyway. I don't know if everybody else thinks it's classic, but I think it's good. I feel like the Ensoniq stuff with the analog filters, like the ESQ1 and the SQ1 and SQ80, I think there's a few others as well, but they have like digital wavetable sort of samples in them, but it's all analog filters. But this is digital filters, and then non-resonant filters as well. So you, like, I'll demonstrate that later, but they don't have any resonant peaks, so they're really interesting sounding. But I feel like that's what makes this synth quite unique. Well, it's one of the things, anyway. This is a pad I made called Leslie Pad, and I called it that because it's using a rotor. A rotor speaker sort of effect on it, but I really like this. It's very it's kind of like a bit Boards of Canada-y maybe. Cool sound. This suspended one is also an original preset, I think. I just really liked it. Pretty cool sound. Angels, pretty sure I made this one. Or at least modified it. Classic 80s sort of sound. This is more of an effect, I think. Pretty cool. This one is also an original preset. It's quite similar to the first one I was playing, I think. This one, I think, it was also a preset. Maybe I got this off the internet or something. Not sure. So long ago now. I don't usually I don't really make many new patches for this. I do have a few newer ones in here, but when I say newer, they're a few years old now, but this one I definitely made. Very, very slow attack on that one. This is just like a pad machine. This is mainly what I use it for, is pads and like sort of like glistening kind of bell polysynths. This one I think is also an original preset. That's all right. I made this one. I called it Oldfield because Mike Oldfield. I think I made this one. Very dreamy. Alright, so these two I made in the last couple of years. This doesn't actually seem like that long ago, but some of these synth sounds I made, you know, probably a decade ago, so. Pretty sort of standard saw wave pad. I'm pretty sure it's using a lot of oscillators. That's why you're getting some of the note stealing there. This one, I think, actually demonstrates one of the unique features of this synth, which is trans waves, which is basically just Ensoniq's way of saying wavetables. So this one sounds like this. Real sort of detuned vibes. I made these two Rhodes sounds. I actually really like them. They're just using sine waves. This one's basically the same, it's just got a bit more. What else have we got here? This one is the first. This was one of the sounds I made, which I then modified and showed earlier. One of my favorite patches that I made for this, I think. What else have we got here? This is an original preset. It's classic VFX sound. Rich. That's how I'd describe that. Floating. What does this sound like? Sounds like I'm floating. LFO City. I'm using the mod wheel there, by the way. Hellpad. And Heavenpad. It's pretty nice. Super Bell. Like, this is one of the cleanest bell sounds ever. I hardly ever use that sound, but it is. The reason I've kept it is just because it, I don't know, it just sort of sounds so sharp. Like it's got such an attack on it. So this sound is one of the sounds I'm sort of most proud of. I've hardly ever used it. I don't know where I would use it, to be honest. It's kind of a bit of a complicated sound, but anyway, this is what it sounds like. So there's a lot of weird shit going on in that one. Some like, I think there's some LFO triggering going. I don't know. I can't remember. It was so long ago that I made that sound. some of the best drum sounds on the planet. I don't know. There's some, that kick's kind of interesting. Oh, that's got a split with a bass. Terrible sound. I don't even know why I've kept it. This one's kind of like faking an arpeggio. So if you do like multiple key hit, like if you just do one, it just does that. But if you sort of time it correctly like this. No MIDI clock going on there. It's all just, you know, off the cuff playing. So I'm just going to find one of these sounds that I don't like. Maybe I'll go to that drum bass one and I'm just going to delete it and start fresh. I don't know if I can remember how to delete a program. I feel like I just have to start fresh, like manually delete it. So let me go to here. This is where we start, and this is the select voice page. You can't really see these buttons over here, but you probably don't need to see them that much, so I'll explain. So this is basically, you've got six oscillators. probably not the best idea to use all six at once, because that just seems a bit crazy. You'd have a massive sound for a start, but also you'd just run out of polyphony. It's only, I think, got like 21 voices or something, and that gets less the more of these you use. So you can solo them as well, so I'm just gonna solo this one. Alright, so let's see if we can select something else. Actually a pretty cool sound just by itself after I fucked with the envelope. But what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna set all of this to maximum. So I'm just gonna put a whole new wave in here. I'm going to demonstrate some trans wave stuff. So I'm going to go to the waveform button and I'm going to select, because in harmonic there's multi-wave, which is like kind of like wave sequencing, and there's drum sounds, multi-drum, there's trans waves. So there's a whole bunch of these. I'm going to start from the first one, this resonant one, or is it the other way? Yeah, that one. So I'm going to modify this. I'm going to mod the wave table with the LFO. So So that's working on that. So there we go. Sorry for the delay. It just takes some time sometimes, especially I haven't used this in a while. And on top of that, I'm starting from there's no way to just initialize a patch on this. So you kind of have to, I don't know, set up your own init patch, and I haven't done that. The Ensoniq TS-12, which I just have sitting below this on the rack, which I'll do another video of another time, but that's very similar to this synth, but it's just got way more features because it's a newer one, and it basically, that one's got an initialized patch on it, which is nice. So that's what the spectral wave sounds like. I'm just going to slow down that LFO. Actually, I'm going to use the mod wheel. Why the hell not? That's better. I can really control it now. So, awesome wavetable capabilities, I reckon. I assume this one came from the ESQ-1. This one is like a pulse width, and I can fake pulse width by using a pulse width wavetable. So if we put this back to the LFO, we'll try and get that working properly. Which just seems to be fucking impossible. That's better. So there's definitely some filtering going on here. There's some on envelope 2. I'm just going to get rid of that entirely. And I'm going to change the mod amount to nothing. And I'm going to show you this filter. So right now it's completely off. It's completely closed. So notice there's no resonance at all. You've got a few different types. You've got a three pole, I guess, and a two pole. So if I... They are different, but quite dramatically. So I'm just going to give it some light filtering. And we're back. I actually found that the problem was I had something glitched out in the effects, and so I was just getting an infinite reverb. It's kind of cool that it exists, but it was kind of fucking me over. So anyway, let's go back to this. Got my pulse. And I was in the middle of filtering. So that's kind of the level of filtering I want. I'm just going to slow down the LFO ever so slightly. I'm just going to increase the mod amount a bit. You got a nice sort of gentle waviness. And so I'm pretty happy with that. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go back to the voice page. I'm going to copy that voice. And then I'm going to go back to the voice page and recall it. So now I've got both them, two of them, and so I'm just going to solo this one, and I'm going to do some slightly different things to this. Like, for a start, I'm going to put a bit of a pitch mod on the LFO as well. And I'm going to slow down the rate as well. It's too much, so I'm going to down a little bit. Maybe a little bit more. So by itself it sounds a bit warped, but if I layer them together, which I am now, the other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to give a little bit more filtering, but I'm going to give a slightly envelope filter. So I'm going to go back to this one. I'm just going to select that, go to the filter, increase the envelope to, and then I'm going to go to envelope 2, and I'm going to change some of the timings on these. So I'm going to give it a bit of an attack, increase the release. And I'm going to copy envelope 2, envelope 2 parameters, copy, and then I'm going to go to voice, select voice 2, go to envelope 2 parameters on that voice, and recall, and I'm going to go yes. And I'm going to change the mod amount, the envelope 2 amount, but I'm going to do it less than the other one, just a little bit. And I'm going to layer them both together again. So the other thing that's going on here, which is slightly annoying, is that whoever made this previous sound had a whole bunch of different things on it, and they split the keyboard. So I'm going to go to, I think it's output, yeah, keyboard scale zone, and it's set to C4 to B5. So I'm going to go there, C2 to C7. So now, I have to do it on both of them though. So I'll go to this one, output. There we go. So now, I can get those high notes as well, which I wasn't being able to get before. So I'm going to do one more thing. I'm going to copy this one again, and then I'm going to copy it there. I'm going to select this one, and I'm going to change the wave to, what we got? Might go just with pulse 1. I'm going to change the pitch octave to 1 octave higher. And I'm going to change the mod amount even further. And the LFO, I'm going to change the speed of it again. It's maybe slightly faster this time, but not too much faster. Change this mod amount. Because the thing about the LFO on this is it's weird. I'm still not 100% sure kind of how it works. You've got all of these mod sources. You can change the mod source of the LFO. Right now I've just got it set to LFO because I'm not really sure what else to set it to. I think I can set it to off. Actually, yeah, I'll set it to off. See? That's actually better. Because it's telling me exactly what it's doing now. So I'll slow it down. On this one slightly as well. I'm going to make it softer. I'm just going to go back to these. Lovely. I'm sure you can attest to that. But one more thing I'm going to do is that all of this, it's all just a little bit too bassy. So I did mention before I've got two filters on here, so I'm going to just go to here, and I'm going to select filter 2. And it's a high, I've got a high, the option to have a high pass filter here. I've got two types of high pass and more low pass filters as well, so I'm just going to select that high pass, and I'm going to remove all of this stuff. I'm going to demonstrate this high pass filter. Again, no resonance. Just gonna trim it off about there. And I'm gonna do the same thing on this one. Fix these LFOs on these particular voices as well. Just turn these mod sources to off, because it's going to be way slower now, but that's nice. So I'm going to increase the speed of it. Yeah, almost get up into audio rates right there. So I'm going to just change the pitch mod a little bit. That speed down a bit more. And I'm going to go back to this voice and I'm going to change the same things. So, look, this is a very complicated synthesizer, but it's very easy to use, in my opinion. Like, I sort of took to it like a duck to water when I first started using it. Granted, I did, like, read the manual a lot, but I just think with this screen, these buttons here and all of the menu buttons, like, it is a digital synth. There's only this like one data fader here. But with that said, you can still easily access everything very quickly. And I do find it's actually kind of a pleasure to use. Like, as far as menu based stuff, I think it's actually quite enjoyable to use. I just think that's worth mentioning. So, all together, I might not actually do any high pass filter on this one because it's a higher octave and I just feel like I don't want it to be too piercing. So I'm just gonna see how this sounds. Save that just quickly to the, where is it? There it is. To the drum and bass program. And I'm going to go back to the voices. And what am I going to do? Oh, that's right. I'm going to go to the effects page. So right now there's a delay reverb on it. I'm just going to basically increase the decay time. Like everything on this synth, the effects are weird. Like, the way they are set up, I'm not really sure a lot of the time what I'm changing sometimes, but so regeneration, that's, you know, feedback. That's cool. I like that. One thing I might do, just for some extra polish, is change some of the panning. So at the moment they're all set right in the middle. I'm going to set and slightly offset each of them. Maybe I'll make this one a bit more central because it's the higher octave one. Just go back to these ones, increase that a little bit more. Say to 65, and on this one to 35. Not really sure if that's a discernible difference, but it will definitely make a difference in a mix. So I'm just gonna write that. Where is it? There. There's one other thing I can do to this. I mean, there's several other things I can do. One thing I could do is to... So I've just got a saw wave here now. With a bit of a slow attack on it. So I'm going to increase the initial. Remove the attack. Very digital sounding wave. I'm just going to go through some of these. Before I continue, I'm going to change the octave because it's really low. So, like, you can give something an interesting transient right at the start. I think it, I mean, I'm not saying it's going to work with this sound, but it could. Interesting. Not sure where that sound went. Seems to have vanished. What the fuck? What happened to that? Did it just went away? It's back now. Weird. So anyway, I'm just gonna mute that. There is one interesting thing about this. One more thing I should probably show you. You can't see over here. In that direction, but over by the mod wheel and the pitch bend, there are two buttons called patch select, and when I hold them down, if you look here, these settings change. So one voice can have the potential to have like multiple different patches in the one voice, and it's kind of a performance thing. So with this one, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make it so one of the patch select buttons is just these two voices, which sounds like this. And when I release it, so you can see how helpful that can be, certainly in a, from a performance context, but I think in the studio it can be good too. So you got two of those. So with this other one, I'm just gonna say get rid of that. And I'm just gonna go with one voice. This first voice that we did. There we go. And I'm gonna write this. And I'm gonna change the name as well. So this is another interesting thing. It's actually changing name. You might think it's going to be terrible. It's not that bad. So I'm just going to call this digital. Digital PWM, maybe. So I'm just going to use these to go to... Where is it? H. Digi... WM. And then this one. Sweet. So, and there it is. So just while, considering I've done making the sound now, I'm just going to tilt this so you can see a little bit more of the synth. Like over here, this is what, like where you're hitting all of the pages, so LFO, multiple envelopes, pitch, pitch mod, filter, output, wave, mod mix. Mod mixer is pretty cool actually. You can mix like different mod sources, like you can mix an LFO with an envelope or an LFO with like pressure and mod wheel and just a whole bunch of things, and you can sort of, I don't know, I guess it's like a way to get different wave shapes in LFOs and stuff like that. It's pretty cool actually. So I think that's gonna do it. This is a great synth. I really love it. I don't think I'll ever sell it. I just will show you this one sound, V resonant. This is another example of trans wave or wave table. And this is one where they've got a wave which has got a resonant filter baked into it. So then it sweeps through the resonant sweep, and it sort of sounds like you've got a, you know, a resonant filter sweep pad. So it sounds like this. If I go to the voice, again, there's different patch settings. So. That's cool. But yeah, like if I go to the resonance page, the resonant voice, you can see that, what am I doing? Here, envelope one, mod amount, trans wave, it's all happening. So that's a pretty extreme example. But anyway, great synth. Highly recommend. I don't think there are any videos like this about this synth on YouTube, so hopefully I'm doing something new here. I hope you enjoyed the video. You should subscribe to my channel. You should watch all of my other videos if you want. Anyway, hope you liked it. See ya.